One of the most beloved games of its generation, The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt has received a so-called next-gen update. While the opinion of what the next-gen is very different for as many people as you ask, it's simple. The next-gen, in this case, means that it is improved for the console generation that comes after PlayStation 4 and Xbox One, meaning that it's enhanced for the next-generation hardware that PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X and S delivers. Next-gen also adds never-before-seen visual effects to the game that ultimately make the game run much worse. With such an update comes great responsibility. Bringing such a drastic change to an older game with a very healthy player base can lead to a catastrophe. Well, we all most likely know what happened. This video almost turned into a history lesson about a disaster this update brought to PC gamers. Let's not go any further into that. Now that we understand what the next gen update is, it is time to see what we can do about the FPS numbers. This is not a typical benchmark video that will show you what it's like to play the game on certain hardware. This is a video that will show you what it's like to improve the performance of the game on certain hardware. Before we proceed with the optimization process, you will need to download and install the LowSpecs Experience. The download link can be found in the description of this video. LowSpecs Experience is a game optimization tool that I developed that will allow you to optimize your favorite games for maximum performance. So, first of all, start the installation process for the LowSpecs Experience. Once it's done, start it from the newly created desktop shortcut and select the optimization catalog. From the top of the menu, select the applicable digital platform and then select The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt from the drop-down menu. Once that is done, press Load the optimization package. LowSpecs Experience will now automatically check if the game version currently installed is supported by this optimization. If it is, press OK and the optimization control panel will load. When the optimization control panel loads, simply select the optimization presets and the resolution you would like to render your game at. This is something you will need to experiment on your own in order to see what works for a system the best. Once you decide which optimization presets and resolution you are going to use, press the Execute Optimization button and then start your game. Also, if you are not satisfied with what you see, you can always restore your game to default settings by choosing the Restore Default option. That's all from me for now. If you like what I do, please be sure to like the video and subscribe for more similar content. Anyway, I will see you all next time.
War is not exactly going our way.
We have a side.
The Northern Realms.
Radovid's realms, don't you mean? Temeria and Edirne are no more.
Radovid's pledged to restore the old borders as soon as he wins the war.
Believe that?
Gotta believe something. It's what keeps us going.
So, a griffin this close to the village? Strange.
My thoughts exactly. In a forest or the mountains, sure, but here? And near the main road.
Maybe it's the war. Corpses everywhere, the stench of blood, burnt flesh. Drives monsters crazy sometimes.
Men, too. We need to watch ourselves in White Orchard. And we should leave as soon as we learn anything.
Kings do the fighting.